Today we're going to go through how you can streamline your production using project templates. Here are a few I've created over the years. This is my recent one. I've been tweaking them every so often until they're perfect for me. So let's go and see how the template looks. Okay, so here we go. This is a beginner's guide, so if you already know what you're doing, then you'll have to just bear with me on this. A lot of people who are aspiring to start producing, or if you've been actually been doing it for a while but just want to streamline your creativity, that's a good way of doing it. The reason why it's a good idea to have templates ready is so you can get straight to music making. So it saves time, and if you've got ideas already running through your head and you want to get them down as quickly as possible, it's all ready and set up for you, so you can get your ideas down nice and quick without faffing about with plugins or VSTs. It's all there ready for you. So the arranger chain, this is basically is a guide. I don't really follow it to the T, but I can just move things around in case I need to change what I'm looking at in the grand scheme of things. And these are my group channels. So basically, this is how I set up my groups. I have effects, drums, bass, synths, and vocals. There's the master stereo out. I just basically use things I normally use, so like and my sweeps. I have already got my sub sorted out here, which is just a sine wave respace in case I need it. I want to show you what I've done with the group tracks, because I use this to do like a master chain, which will apply the effects to every channel I add here. So yeah, rooted to drums. This isn't. I don't root the kick to the drums because it flattens it too much. All effects go here. Drums. I have a parallel compression on it. Yeah. Bass, if you're rooting VSTs into it, just open it up, and this will be rooted here to the bass. So that's my sub going into the bass here. I also have the Reese doing the same thing. I also have already got my plugins sorting out the Reese. That's all ready for me to go. Yeah, so synths would be for like pads, plucks, background sort of thing. Leads, obviously the lead. This is actually my RD2000, my Roland digital piano. I record it through here. I also record the MIDI notes, so I can change the MIDI notes and re-record it back in if I play a bum note or something. Vocals, obviously, if I'm having vocals, I put them in here. I don't know if I've got any effects on there. No, not yet. But if I do, one of the plugins I do use is called Nectar 3. Absolute beast of a plugin. Literally just add it on top and it makes it sound good. It just works really well, you know. I'm just playing this in. Yeah, so there you go. Also chords, these are just the basic pads that I use in the background for texture. Normally I just apply what I want here, filter out those harsher frequencies. I'm going to try open a new thing. Basically all the same principle. I always have these group tracks, they're very important. I've got a lot more synths in this one. So I hope it's been quite insightful to you. You can expect more in-depth things in future. I will be doing more musical composition style tutorials. I feel like a lot of tutorial producers nowadays, they focus on sound design, and while, you know, I feel like I'm more versed in the composition side of things, which might be more helpful to you. I know a lot of you like the melodies I make, and I'm going to try and share how I do those with all of you in the future episodes. So stay tuned, and thank you for listening, guys. Have a good day.